Have you ever been told to just move on or get over it after experiencing something traumatic? If you have, you know that it's not that simple. Trauma isn't just a bad memory that we can choose to forget or a wound that heals naturally over time. It's much more complex than that, affecting both the mind and the body in profound ways. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. Today, I want to talk about why trauma isn't just something you can just get over and why understanding the science behind it is essential for healing. When we talk about trauma, we're not just talking about the event itself, but the lingering impact that it has on your brain and body. To understand why trauma is so hard to get over, we first need to look at what happens in the brain and body when we experience something traumatic. Trauma is a complex psychological and physiological response to experiences that overwhelm a person's capacity to cope. It's often associated with a single life-threatening event like accidents or assaults, but trauma can also result from prolonged exposure to chronic stressors, such as abuse, neglect, or systemic oppression. Psychologically, trauma occurs when an event or a series of events profoundly impacts a person's sense of safety, identity, and worldview. It's important to note that trauma is subjective. What's traumatic for one person may not be for another, depending on factors like personal history, support systems, and neurobiological resilience. I talk more about how to build up your resilience in another video that I'll have linked in this video. When you experience trauma, several key areas of your brain are impacted. The amygdala, often referred to as the brain's fear center, becomes hyperactive. This heightened state of alertness is why trauma survivors often feel anxious or on edge even when there's no immediate danger. The amygdala remains in a constant state of vigilance, scanning for potential threats and making it hard to relax or feel safe. Your hippocampus, which is central to forming and retrieving memories, can actually shrink in response to trauma. And this structural change affects how memories are stored and recalled, which is why people with trauma often experience fragmented, distorted, or intrusive memories of the event. And traumatic memories don't get processed the same way that other memories do. Instead, they get stuck and resurface as vivid flashbacks or nightmares. Then there's the prefrontal cortex, which is normally responsible for rational thinking, decision-making, and impulse control. Trauma survivors have reduced activity in the prefrontal cortex, making it difficult to regulate emotions, concentrate, or make decisions, especially in stressful situations. Trauma doesn't just affect the mind, it affects the body as well. When we experience trauma, our body's natural response is to activate our fight, flight, or freeze mode, which is a natural survival mechanism. And this response results in the release of stress hormones like cortisol and adrenaline. These hormones prepare us to either confront the threat, escape from it, or become immobilized if we have no other options. But if you've experienced trauma, this stress response can become chronically activated, even when the immediate threat has passed. And this is where trauma becomes stored, if you will, in your body. This persistent release of stress hormones can lead to a range of physical symptoms, including muscle tension, chronic pain, digestive issues, and fatigue. Trauma survivors often report they feel perpetually exhausted, on edge, or trapped in an endless cycle of stress. Trauma changes your brain and body in ways that are hard to reverse without targeted interventions. But the concept of neuroplasticity offers hope. Neuroplasticity is the brain's ability to form new neural connections. By the way, when I was in residency in the late 1990s, we still believed that the brain was largely fixed and unchangeable. How depressing is that? It's only been in the last 25 years that the concept of neuroplasticity has been fleshed out with advances in neuroimaging, and now it's fundamental to our understanding of how the brain works. So the ability to change the brain can go both ways. Trauma can create maladaptive pathways and shrink brain regions, but there are several treatment approaches that can allow for healing the brain from trauma through adaptive rewiring. Let's look at some evidence-based therapies for trauma. One such therapy is eye movement desensitization and reprocessing, or EMDR. EMDR is a therapy that involves processing traumatic memories by stimulating both sides of your brain, usually through guided eye movements. This process helps to rewire the brain's response to traumatic memories by reducing their emotional intensity. It allows the brain to reintegrate the memories without the same emotional overwhelm. Another highly effective method is trauma-focused cognitive behavior therapy. This CBT works by helping you identify and change unhelpful thought patterns and behaviors associated with your trauma. Trauma-focused CBT includes exposure therapy, where you gradually face the trauma memories or situations in a controlled and safe manner. This gradual exposure desensitizes you to the experiences that trigger anxiety, and your anxiety reduces over time. Somatic therapies are also gaining recognition in trauma treatment. Unlike therapies that mainly focus on thoughts and emotions, somatic therapies focus on the body. Techniques like somatic experiencing and sensory motor psychotherapy work on the premise that trauma is stored not just in the mind, but in your body's nervous system. And these therapies involve tuning into physical sensations in the body to release stored tension and calm the body's stress response. These therapies help restore a sense of safety and physical self-awareness, allowing trauma survivors to reconnect with their bodies in a healthier, more integrated way. This outcome is called embodiment and is an important aspect of trauma recovery because being able to tune into and understand your bodily sensations helps with recognizing and managing emotional responses to stress. I know that's a lot. Let me say that again. In order to manage your emotional and physical stress response, you need to get good at being able to tune in to your body's sensations and reactions. Mind-body practices like mindfulness, yoga, and breathwork also help cultivate a sense of embodiment. Mindfulness involves staying present with your experiences without judgment. For trauma survivors, mindfulness helps reduce anxiety and improve emotional regulation by training the brain to remain anchored in the present rather than getting swept away with traumatic memories or worries. Yoga has also been shown to help release tension stored in the body and promote relaxation. Specifically, trauma-informed yoga focuses on creating a safe space for participants, allowing them to reconnect with their bodies and regain a sense of control. Similarly, breathwork techniques like deep breathing or diaphragmatic breathing can help calm the autonomic nervous system, reducing the body's fight or flight response and promoting a state of rest and healing. Another important aspect of trauma recovery is practicing self-compassion. Healing from trauma is rarely a linear process. There will be good days and bad days, and you have to treat yourself with kindness rather than judgment. Self-compassion involves recognizing that suffering is a part of the human experience and that you have to treat yourself with the same care that you would offer a loved one. Research shows that self-compassion can reduce the negative effects of trauma by promoting emotional resilience and reducing feelings of shame or self-blame. Simple practices like journaling, spending time in nature, or engaging in creative outlets can be forms of self-care and support healing. Journaling, for example, can provide an outlet to process and release difficult emotions. Nature walks can promote relaxation and provide a grounding experience, helping to soothe the nervous system. By combining evidence-based therapies with mind-body practices and self-compassion, trauma survivors can have multiple options for healing. Trauma is a complex experience that requires equally complex strategies to heal. But the good news is that with the right support and interventions, it's possible to rewire your brain and body toward resilience and recovery. Watch this video for more on how trauma affects our memories. Thanks for watching today. See you next time.